Hello students, last presentation we had discussed on abrasive jet machine AJM. Today we will discuss on ultrasonic machining USM. In ultrasonic machining we cover the introduction, principle of working, setup of USM, advantages of USM, disadvantages of USM and application of USM. Introduction. Ultrasonic machining is a non-traditional process in which abrasive contained in slurry are driven against the work by a tool oscillating at low amplitude and high frequency. Ultrasonic machining is an essential and abrasion or erosion process which make use of ultrasonic vibration, that is vibration of the frequency above that of upper frequency limit of the human ear. The wave which have a frequency above 16 kHz are not sonic and are called as ultrasonic waves. These waves have frequency above that of upper frequency limit of the human ear and are not audible to human ear. Principle of working ultrasonic machining. It consists of an electromechanical transducer connected to the AC supply, velocity transformer which holds the tool firmly. An abrasive gun is used to supply an abrasive slurry, which is mixture of abrasive grain and water in between tool and workpiece interface under the definite pressure. When the AC power is supplied with high frequency, the transducer starts vibrating longitudinally, which is transmitted to the penetrating tool through a mechanical focusing device called velocity transformer. As the tool vibrates, it is pressed on the work surface with light force and allowing the abrasive slurries to flow through between tool workpiece interface. The impact force arising out of the vibration of the tool end and the flow of abrasive slurry causing thousands of microscopic grains to remove from work material by abrasion. Abrasive like aluminum oxide, silicon carbide can be used. The tool is made up of soft ductile material like copper or brass and soft steel or stainless steel. Setup of ultrasonic machining. First, power supply. To start the machining process, power is required. This is essential. As the diagram showing, the first is connected to the power supply. Second, electromechanical transducer. An electromechanical transducer connected to the AC supply. The transducer converts an electrical signal to the mechanical signal, whereas electromechanical transducer used to generate a mechanical vibration. Third, tool. The tool should be designed as like when the operation is performed does not lead to brittle fracture of it. Therefore, the tool is made up of tough, strong and ductile material like steel, stainless steel, HSS, or mild steel. Fourth, abrasive slurry. A water-based slurry of abrasive particles used as an abrasive slurry in this machining. Aluminum oxide, silicon carbide are used as an abrasive particles in this slurry. Fifth, abrasive gun. An abrasive gun is used to supply an abrasive slurry which is mixture of abrasive grain and the water in between tool workpiece interface under a definite pressure. 6. Tool feed mechanism. As the tool machines the workpiece, the gap between the two increases. Thus, for machining action, the tool must be fed continuously into the workpiece. This is done by a tool feed mechanism which uses counterweight for the purpose. The tool is pressed against the workpiece with a load of few kilograms and feed downwards continuously as the cavity is cut in the workpiece. Advantages of ultrasonic machining. It can be used machine hard, brittle, fragile and non-conductive material. No heat is generated in work. Therefore, no significant changes in physical structure of work material. Non-metal that cannot be machined by EDM and ECM can very well be machined by ultrasonic machining. It is burrless and distortionless process. It can be adopted in conjunction with other new technology like EDM, ECG and ECM. Disadvantage of ultrasonic machine. Low metal removal rate. It is difficult to drill deep holes as slurry movement is restricted. Tool wear rate is high due to abrasive particles. Power consumption is quite high. Application of ultrasonic machines. Cutting of industrial diamonds. In making hole of any shape for which the tool can be made. Machining of cavities in electrically non-conductive ceramics. Use in machining of dies for wire drawing, punching and blanking operations. Thank you.